Hey guys, this is question MM071 of the Maths Methods Sharpened Study Guide. So we've got on the axes below, sketch the graph of f of x equals 2 plus 3 over x plus 2 squared, where the domain is all real numbers except for negative 2. Label all axes, axis intercepts, and any asymptotes. So we've got our axis here, and I'm just going to rewrite the equation at the top so we can keep track of it all. We've got f of x equals 2 plus 3 over x plus 2 squared. Now, with this sort of question, just keep in mind that we don't actually have to show any working for intercepts or asymptotes. All we need to do is make sure that they're labeled on the graph. So our first step for this question is actually recognizing what kind of graph this is. So because we've got a number over x squared, that's actually what's called a truncus, which has the general shape like this. Sort of looks like a tree trunk. You've got a vertical asymptote and a horizontal asymptote that the truncus has to follow. So first things first, I like to take care of my asymptotes first because they're quite easy to actually see. So whatever your constant is on the end, usually it's on the end, but it's just whatever number is by itself, that's your horizontal asymptote. So because this is a 2, our horizontal asymptote is actually at y equals 2. This number here in the bracket represents our vertical asymptote. So whatever number x has to equal to make this bottom part equal 0, that's where your asymptote occurs. So if x was negative 2, this bottom part would be 0, which means that our asymptote occurs at x equals negative 2, which runs down here. And now all we need to do is actually work out what our intercepts are. So I can already see that there's actually not going to be any x-intercepts. And the reason why is because of this rough sketch that I've just done over here. So I know that because this is a positive truncus, the graph is actually going to run along here and down here, which means that it's actually not going to cross the x-intercept at all. The x-axis at all, because it can't go past this asymptote. So we're actually going to only need to work out our y-intercepts. So how do we work out a y-intercept? So y-int when x equals 0. So whenever you want to work out a y-intercept, you just let x equal 0. So f of 0 equals 2 plus 3 over 0 plus 2 squared. What happens is we get 2 plus 3 over 2 squared, which equals 2 plus 3 over 4. Now, this might be a little hard to see where this would be on a graph. But if you're unsure, this is simply 2 3/4. But we need to get it in a form that we can write as a coordinate. So this becomes 8 4 plus 3 4, which equals 11 4. Which means that our y-intercept is 0, 11 4. Now I know that 11 4 is 2 3/4. So that's going to roughly go here. And now all we need to do is draw a graph. We only have one y-intercept. We don't have any x-intercepts, and that's all we need to do. So wow, that was actually pretty decent. So the most important part when drawing these graphs is that your graph always looks like it's moving towards the asymptote. If your graph at the end here, for example, flicks upwards, wrong, because it has to always be approaching the asymptote. In year 12, I lost a mark because my graph slightly curved upwards, which didn't represent what an asymptote was meant to be. So don't curve it upwards. If you need to, even finish the graph a little early. I haven't actually gone all the way to the end, but just make sure that it is always going downwards. It doesn't have to be perfect, but it has to be pretty damn close. So, is our graph finished? No. Label everything. So we've got our y-intercept here, which, like we said before, was 0, 11 4. We've got our asymptotes, which is x equals negative 2 and y equals 2. And that's it. So we've labeled our asymptotes. We've drawn our asymptotes. We've drawn our graph. and we've also drawn in our intercepts, and that's it. And this is actually worth 3 marks. With graphs, it's hard to sort of justify where they give the marks, but I like to think that they give you all the marks to start with and then start taking off marks based on what you didn't include. So if you, for example, if you didn't include this y-intercept but you did everything else, you'd get 2 marks. If you didn't include the labels of the asymptotes also, and you didn't include the label of the y-intercept, you'd get 1 mark. So it's sort of like a trade-off. So they start with giving you all the marks and then they start taking off marks based on what you didn't do. But this is exactly how you should draw this graph. And let us know in the comments if you have any questions below.